Let's see. Loading. And I think we should be live. Hello, everyone. Good evening. My name is Julia Desario, Miss Gastonia 2020 through the Miss America organization. And welcome to my fourth virtual talent show as a part of my social impact initiative, Art, the Highest Form of Hope. I'm so excited tonight because in past talent shows, we have featured some incredible students who have lost opportunities to perform in their specific areas due to COVID-19. Last month, we highlighted Black artists and works from Black artists to amplify their voices and allow them to sit on our shoulders for an evening and share works that were important and meaningful to them. And so tonight, I'm excited because we have the Miss America organization title holders with us. We have a handful of pageant ladies with us from across the country, and I'm so excited to feature them tonight. We have 7 performances that we are going to be showing, and this will also allow us a little bit of an opportunity to talk with the title holders, hear a little bit about the organization if you're interested, and learn about the women who wear the crown and just how talented and exceptional they are and how they serve their communities and the organization. So thanks for tuning in tonight. I'm so excited that you're here. And without further ado, we are going to get started with our first contestant, we're not competing here, but our first performer, Miss Jenna Martorana. I hope I said that right. We didn't have a chance to go over that before we started. So I'm going to unmute you, maybe. This is a beautiful day to learn how to use technology. Hi, Jenna.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I am great. Now that we are starting our show tonight, tell us a little bit about yourself, who you are, and just any information you'd like us to know about you.
Well, I'm Jenna Martorana. I am Miss Liberty Bell from Pennsylvania. My talent is obviously color guard, and my social impact initiative is #CureStigma.
Awesome. Do you want to tell us a little bit about your talent and kind of how you got involved with color guard?
So I became involved in color guard in 2009 when I started 9th grade. I've been a baton twirler since I was 4, but unfortunately my high school and my college did not allow twirlers, so I got involved in color guard. And when I started competing in the Miss America organization in 2018, I knew I wanted to be the first to bring color guard to the Miss Pennsylvania stage.
Very, very cool. I love that. And I love that you were just bringing what you do. And I think that's the really special thing about tonight's show, folks, is that everybody has such a unique talent and they're just owning it. And I love that so much. Tell us a little bit about your social impact initiative and kind of how you got connected with that.
So I knew as soon as I started competing that obviously I wanted to do something related to mental health. As somebody with depression, anxiety, and body dysmorphia, I knew that mental health was important to me, and that is where my passion lied. And after I won my first title, I started becoming involved with the National Alliance on Mental Illness. There's National Alliance, and then there are chapters throughout the country within your local counties. And I became involved with some of the local chapters around here and really found my passion for mental health and being an advocate for people like myself with mental health conditions.
That's incredible. And guys, if you don't know much about the Miss America organization, I think a lot of times from the surface, if you're not really involved and you see, if you go to a competition or things like that, you really just see the outward work that we do as far as evening gown and pretty hair and makeup. But a lot of people don't recognize or know, really have exposure to the fact that Miss America organization title holders are incredibly active in their communities and very passionate young women who have goals and are really using this organization to fulfill those. So I love hearing that, Jenna. I think that's all that I want to ask you. I don't want to grill you or anything, give you a full Miss Pennsylvania interview, but she is going to grace us with her talent. So whenever you're ready, Jenna.
Thank you.
been here before. I know this room, I walk this floor. I used to live alone before I knew ya. Seen your flag on the moral arch, and love is not a victory march. It's cold and it's a broken hallelujah.
Beautiful job.
Thank you.
I was in high school marching band, and I always kind of secretly wanted to be on the color guard because I got to do cool stuff like that. And I just find it so impressive, all of the work that goes into the rifles. And honestly, guys, if you don't know much about color guard, they do rifles. Sometimes they have, I don't know if you call them swords or if there's a specific sabers. That, look, Mr. Vanderford would be upset with me. Sabers, I knew that. And the flag work, I mean, it's just gorgeous. So thank you so much for sharing that beautiful, beautiful talent with us and spending your evening over here with Ms. Gastonia.
Thank you so much for having me.
Anytime. Listen, anytime, y'all. I love it. Next on the agenda, we have a teen title holder from right here in North Carolina, Miss Mackenzie Cox. I am going to share her screen so you can see her. Hello. So Mackenzie, tell us who you are and a little bit about yourself.
Absolutely. Well, first, great job, Jenna. I wish I was that coordinated, but I think Mackenzie doing color guard would be kind of dangerous. But I am a vocalist. That's what I'm going to be doing tonight. I am Miss Statesville's outstanding teen. This is my third year in the program, and I absolutely love it. The amount of confidence that I've gained, scholarships, personal growth, is just immeasurable. As I said, I serve the community of Statesville, and I use my social impact initiative, Road to Literacy, Reading Opens All Doors. It's a 501c3 nonprofit that I founded to combat illiteracy in my home state of North Carolina. I collect books, I work with our state and local government to create proclamations and legislation that supports literacy. And of course, I established little free libraries, but I do love the arts. I think there's a misconception that because I promote literacy, I'm not involved with the arts and humanities, but I'm so excited to be here tonight and to share my love for singing with you all.
We are excited to experience your love for singing, and I'm so excited. I've not gotten to hear you sing yet, so this is like a special little treat for me. I'm so excited.
Oh, goodness.
And I think you did a great job kind of explaining your social impact initiative and like that. So honestly, I want to ask you, because we talked a little bit about it earlier, college plans, since you're a teenie, I'd love to hear a little bit about what you'd like to do in the future and kind of how the Miss America organization connects to that.
Absolutely. I am looking to pursue a degree in communications. I'm not exactly sure where I'm going to end up yet for school. I'm only 16, so I'll be going into my junior year. But the college search is not exactly what I imagined, since most of it is now virtual and we're not really doing campus tours. But I think having experience with the Miss America organization has given me the confidence to be able to speak in front of people, which is a crucial part of a communications career. So it's something that I'm looking forward to.
Very cool. Well, we are excited to hear your beautiful voice whenever you are ready.
Thank you. Here, let me just get my track started.
To dream the impossible dream, to fight the unmeetable foe, to bear with unbearable sorrow, to reach the unreachable star,
This is my quest, to follow that star, no matter how hopeless, no matter how far, to fight for the right, without question or pause, to be willing to march and to help with a heavenly cause. And I know, if I'll only go through to this glorious quest, that my heart will be peaceful and calm when I'm laid to my rest. And the world will be better for this, that one man, born in cover with scars, he's still strong with his last ounce of courage to reach the unreachable star.
I just realized y'all couldn't see my hand motions.
Well, I really just enjoyed listening to your voice, so there you go.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
That was so beautiful. And you know what's really funny? I would have never guessed you were an alto, but you're giving me all of the alto vibe, and I love that so much.
Thank you.
Yes, ma'am. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Statesville's outstanding teen, Mackenzie Cox. Up next, let's see if I can switch video over a little bit. Next up, we have Miss Megan. You're actually going to have to help me with your last name. Sinisi.
Yes.
Very cool. So we have Miss Sinisi from Pennsylvania as well, just like Jenna earlier. So I'm going to spotlight your video. Tell us hello, tell us who you are, and a little bit about yourself.
Hi, everybody. My name is Megan Sinisi. As Julia introduced me, I am Miss Central Pennsylvania. I'm from Central Pennsylvania in a little town called Altoona, and I've lived here my whole life, but now I'm currently pursuing a master's degree in speech-language pathology at the University of Missouri. So I have just 1 year left, and my social impact initiative is titled From a New Perspective, which actually ties into my career as a speech pathologist. It works with children with autism and families with autism to help assist them with growing through the diagnosis and receiving services that they deserve and they need, including speech pathology services. And I'm very excited because I just established From a New Perspective as an official nonprofit organization. So I'm excited to see what the Miss America organization, as well as my career, can help propel for these families with autism.
An incredible achievement and an incredible work that you're doing.
Thank you.
Yeah, absolutely. I want to ask you, since you are a college gal, yes, and you've been competing in the organization for a while, you said this is your sixth year. So yes, how much scholarship money have you earned through the Miss America organization?
I just calculated it the other day, and I've earned nearly $10,000 towards my education. So that fortunately helps me with my undergraduate student loans that I've already accrued and now pursuing my master's degree. So the Miss America organization is where it's at. For anybody who's looking for scholarship opportunities, please reach out to one of our local title holders, invest in the Miss America organization, because it is such a tremendous way to earn scholarship and pursue the career of your dreams.
Absolutely. Yes, ma'am. We love to hear it. $10,000. All right. Well, thank you so much for chatting with me. And I am actually going to be helping Megan get her music up. So as she gets prepared, I'm going to be playing her music for her.
I'm just going to maneuver myself over into my yard.
And guys, this is the great thing about these virtual talent shows is, you know, you can do your talent anywhere. You don't necessarily have to have a stage to perform and to share your gifts. And I'm really thankful to Zoom, shout out Zoom, for the connections that you've allowed me to make as Miss Gastonia with all of these incredible women and former participants in our talent shows.
And I suppose I missed introducing my talent. So my talent will be baton twirling. I've been twirling since I was 3 years old. And I was very fortunate to be the featured baton twirler at Syracuse University for my undergraduate career. And I'm very excited to showcase that all for you tonight. Thank you, Julia.
Absolutely. And I will hit play whenever you are set.
Alrighty.
too late for second guessing. Too late to go back to sleep. It's time to trust my instincts. Close my eyes and leave. Someone says they're so. Some things I cannot change. Until I try, I'll never know.
My gosh. I think my draw was dropped for most of that performance. I'm not even gonna lie. I'm just
Thank you so much.
You know, I don't know that we have any baton twirlers in North Carolina. Not currently, at least, unless there are some in the teen, Mackenzie. I'm not quite sure. Yeah, so I mean that's kind of new to me. I mean, I've seen people do it before, but oh my gosh, that was really great.
Thank you. And as Jenna said, she's a sister queen of mine in Pennsylvania. She's also a baton twirler, so we have that in common.
I love that. Making connections through the sisterhood.
Absolutely. I love it as well. Thank you so much for having me.
Absolutely. Thank you for sharing your beautiful, beautiful baton twirling with us.
Thank you.
Let me see if I can switch over to here. All right. So next up, we have a sister queen from North Carolina, one of my Miss Sister Queens, Miss Maddie McFarland. So I'm going to share my screen so you can see her and we will get to say hello. Hey, Maddie.
Hey, how are you?
Good. How are you?
I am fabulous. Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Anytime. Listen, I'm so glad that all of you guys have decided to spend your Friday night hanging out and just sharing your gifts. So introduce yourself, tell us who you are and a little bit about yourself.
Hey guys, so my name is Madalena McFarland. I go by Maddie because it's a little bit shorter and a little bit easier. It is my first year actually being a competitor in the Miss America organization. But the Miss America organization has basically always been a part of my life. I started competing in pageants when I was 5 years old and then took a little break and then decided once I was in my sophomore year of college at the age of 18 that I wanted to go ahead and start pursuing competing again. And I knew it was time that I really wanted to compete for the Miss America crown. So with my title, I am currently Miss Wilson. So I represent a beautiful county and city. It's actually the 10th largest city in North Carolina, about an hour east of Raleigh, which is our capital city. Fun fact is that I wear my first Miss America pin I ever got at my first Miss America pageant when I was 6 years old on my banner and whenever I go and meet people. And that way I always have the crown on me no matter where I am. Even if I don't have the big one, I always at least have a little one with me. And probably my proudest accomplishment is that I lead a organization called Hand in Hand, Together We Stand, focusing on advocating to and for our veterans and active duty service members about mental health care and the importance of understanding that vulnerability is strength.
Absolutely. And I love, you know, kind of where you come from with your platform. And if you guys don't follow her social media, she does an excellent job of honestly using her platform, not only just to support her social impact initiative, but honestly to uplift and amplify the voices of all community members. So that's something I really admire about you, Maddie. Very much so. And because we are both new in the organization, this is both of our first years, we kind of have that connection with one another, which is awesome. So based on that, I do want to ask you a question. For anybody who might be watching tonight and might be interested in getting involved with the organization, maybe not necessarily competing, but in other ways, just kind of what advice would you give them?
I would say go for it. Being a volunteer, being a competitor, being a director, and there are lots of different ways to get involved. I know for one, our amazing state director, Beth Knox, actually started as, I guess you could call her a house mother. And she used to be the volunteer that basically reins us in and hurdles us and makes sure we don't go anywhere during our week at Miss North Carolina. And now we all stay in the dorm and we're with our roommates and we're not doing anything too wild and crazy. But one of the best ways to get started is to go either to your local competitions website or to your state competition website. So for us, it is the missnc.org. And if you go to that website, you can go to become a volunteer, find out all the information. Another great way to get involved is if you are, I don't remember the exact age requirement. I believe it's 18 or older. You do have the capability as well to become a judge, which is another great way to help diversify and broaden our spectrum of who we are with the Miss America organization and the Miss North Carolina organization.
You just spat off all of that information she was looking for. I didn't even tell her that question beforehand, y'all. That was impressive. Awesome. Thank you so much for all of that information, Maddie. And now it is time to share your beautiful gift with us. So I will stop talking and let you do that.
All right. So I'm going to be singing a cappella because trying to find the right music can be kind of a thing. I'll be singing Astonishing from the musical Little Women. I thought home was all I'd ever want. My attic, all I'd ever need. Now nothing feels the way it was before, and I don't know how to proceed. I only know I'm meant for something more. I've got to know if I can be astonishing. Oh, find my way. I'll find it far away. I'll find it in the unexpected and the unknown. I'll find my life in my own way. Today, surrendering modesty and grace. I will not disappear without a trace. I'll shout and start a riot. Be anything but quiet. Christopher Columbus, I'll be astonishing. Maddie, you have such power behind your voice. I love it. And I know that I can genuinely like feel what you're singing. And that's something that I think is just so beautiful in an artist. So thank you for sharing your heart with us and your beautiful voice. And I actually have never heard music from that musical. So that made me want to go check it out. Because I really, Mackenzie shaking her head and said, she said it's good. Yeah. I've never, just the words really are what captivated me so much. And that melody is very beautiful too. So thank you for sharing that and opening that door. Thank you for having
me. And for being with us tonight. I appreciate it so much.
Thank you.
Yes, ma'am. All right, everybody. Let's see who's next on our list. Okay, I'm really excited. So our final two participants, one is going to be performing live for us, and the other has submitted a video. She can't be here live, but really wanted to share her gift. So we'll be playing her video and kind of sharing the screen. But both of these talents, I think when you think about the Miss America stage, you would consider them to be more unconventional. But if you have any connection to the organization, or even if you watched the Miss America competition in December, you know that our current Miss America, Camille Schrier, won with a very unconventional talent. She is a scientist, and she did a science experiment and won Miss America, which I think is incredible. And it's a great example to young women who want to get involved with the organization that you don't have to sing or dance necessarily to be successful in the organization. So these two upcoming talents are not what you would consider the normal or the typical Miss America type talents, but I think you're going to be incredibly impressed and really connect with both of them. So I am going to share my screen with Miss Jocelyn Garcia, and she's going to introduce herself and tell us where she's from, which is really fun.
Okay, so I'm Jocelyn Garcia. I'm Miss Anaheim. Anaheim's a city in California. Disneyland's in Anaheim.
And that's all you need to know, folks.
No, that's awesome. So many other things, and they're like, anything else? And I'm like, oh, well, there's Disneyland. And they're like, oh, okay, yeah, that.
Yeah, that place, right? Yeah, that's like your trademark. I love it. Well, Jocelyn, you said you're Miss Anaheim. Tell us a little bit about how you got involved in the organization and a little bit about your social impact initiative, maybe some about your talent, just whatever you feel like sharing.
Okay, so how I got involved in the Miss America organization. So when I was 16, I told myself, you know what? I really want to do pageants. I don't know what it was. I've never been into things that are stereotypically considered girly, but I just randomly was just sitting one summer and I was like, you know what? I'm going to do pageants. I'm going to look into it and I'm going to do it. And I remember I was a senior in high school and I tried doing the Miss Tustin pageant, but they made it difficult for me to enter, so I didn't end up doing it. But I told myself freshman year of college, I was like, you know what, this is the year. I don't care if they tell me I can't do it, I'm gonna do it. They're gonna let me in. And I went over and I'm pretty much ranting at the Miss Tustin director, and they were like, oh no, don't worry, like you just need to do this and you can participate. And I was like, oh, okay. So I went in, didn't win. Then I kept participating in a bunch of other pageants that I qualified for. I became like a pageant junkie. Just kind of seeing like, oh, okay, this says I could go to school here and participate. Oh, I go to school there, I can do it. Oh, this says I got to work here. Oh, okay, good, I can do it. I just going down the list and seeing what I qualify for. And 11 pageants later, the city of Anaheim gave me the opportunity to represent their city. So that was pretty cool. About my talent, I can't sing, I can't dance, I can't roller skate. I can't do anything that I've seen a lot of these amazing women do, but I can rap all right. So I figure, why not do that? I like going on stage, hyping people up. It's a good time for me. So, I mean, if I'm having fun, it's got to be good, right?
Yeah, absolutely. And you know, I love hearing about your journey through the organization and just about your perseverance and saying, no, this is a dream of mine and I'm going to pursue it and find the right place. And, you know, everything happens for a reason. So I know that the city of Anaheim is incredibly blessed to have you as their representative. And I kind of want to ask you a little bit more about your talent. So you said, you know, you can't sing, can't dance. It's like not your jam, not up your alley. So how did you get involved with rap? Like, how did you know that that was the thing that you wanted to do on stage?
Okay, so this actually goes back to middle school. All my siblings, my mom, my grandma are blessed with a great voice. They can all sing. My sisters are amazing at dancing. All my siblings have all these like talents and I'm over here trying to catch on and be like, you know what, I think it looks pretty good. And then they do it and I'm like, oh wait, well, there goes that. And I remember I just started like listening to the radio and kind of just like rapping along with artists and stuff like that. And my siblings were like, hey, you're like actually on the beat, like it sounds pretty okay. And then people at school started talking about it. And then everyone started calling me rapper chick. And they would always come up to me and they'd be like, hey, you're the rapper chick, rap something for us. And I'd be like, okay. And then I'd just do it. And then I remember they called me up to go rap something at a school dance. So that was pretty cool. And just starting in this organization, I knew that was gonna be my talent. Like there was no like, oh, like maybe I'll try to sing for this. No, there was no other thing, it was just this. And I started covering, but then I decided, you know what, I'm gonna write something. I write, but sometimes it's kind of personal. But then I finally wrote something where I was like, you know what, I don't really care. It's not that personal. People are talking about it anyway. Like, let's just do it. So here I am.
I love that. And, you know, I, as a chorus teacher, as a musician, you know, I kind of grew up very surrounded by music, and it's an incredibly important part of my life. So hearing about you connecting with your craft on that personal level is so important. And I admire your bravery in being able to share those personal stories through your music too, because that's what really helps connect people. And I think that's really what the arts are all about. So I love that. I love it, love it, love it. All right, girl, without further ado, I'm so excited. I have not heard her rap yet, y'all, so I cannot wait.
Be careful. Careful. All right. Let me try to. All right. Okay. All right. Yo. Looking at the heavens, got me crying, got me stressing. Hate to start it, bro, because I don't want you all depressing. Yeah, we all got issues, homeless, no job, mental illness, but we gotta stick together and support because it's the illest. Lately in America, we caught up in some drama. Twitter, Trisha, Trigger, girl, don't even get me started. We distracted them, we angered by the words they be submitting when we got a world that's crumbling down to itty bitty pieces. Victims of technology, division of the parties, and it's getting to the point where we ain't even got no smarties. Caging kids up, no illegal, talking trash because it's legal, leaving no consideration, only red, blue, white, and ego. All right, I hope everyone's having a really good time. I usually switch up the rap here to Spanish, so like. Siendo bien latina, mexicana y orgullosa, lo que haga el presidente, como ves que no me asusta, hay que ser inteligente, hablo, deja informarse que aquí cada candidato tiene cola que pisarle, manos bien arriba, no en el fuego para nadie, hay políticos corruptos, como para qué confiarse, tenemos que unirnos, inmigrantes todos somos, no me salgas con atadas, yo inmigrante, pero como, se ha llevado lejos por ayuda externa, por José Juan y María, y la gente de otra tierra, deja ya las payasadas del racismo y esta regata, y abre bien los ojos que en un triste el mundo acaba.
Oh my gosh, y'all, I can't see any of the other queens that are going because I have Jocelyn's pinned to the screen, but I don't know about y'all if you could see my face, but I was just like, oh my gosh, the entire time. Yes, Mackenzie said mind blown. Absolutely. Whoa. I don't know what I was expecting, but like, gosh, you blew every expectation. Like, that was awesome.
Thank you so much. Thank you. I had a good time writing that one. I wrote that in 10 minutes.
That's awesome. And also very incredible. 10 minutes. And, you know, I don't know if you could hear some of the words that she shared, but I mean, tell us a little bit, if it was a little bit too fast for some people who may have not been able to catch all the words, tell us a little bit about like what you were rapping about. Cause I heard a couple of things in there that I really loved.
It's kind of political. It's definitely political. I think I wrote this about a year ago when, you know, these past 4 years have been really interesting for the people here in America, not just for older people, but also for our youth. Everyone sees things differently. Everybody's affected by things differently. And I guess I'm just giving everyone, you know, kind of my point of view, the way I see things happening in America right now, and how they're affecting me. And the part in Spanish talks a little bit about immigration, people that come here illegally, illegal aliens, all that kind of stuff. And it's kind of just, you know, do your research before you run your mouth. That's pretty much what it is. And I enjoyed, those were the best 10 minutes of my life, just writing that. You know, when you really know, when you got an idea, you just kind of, and then all of a sudden,
jot it down and let it live in that space and then create on top of that. And I love that. And I love where your heart came from and, you know, wanting to share your heart and your message through your talent as well. So thank you so much for sharing that with us and being a part of this. I'm cheesing from ear to ear. That was incredible.
Thank you so much.
Yes.
Thank you so much for this opportunity.
Anytime. Listen, this is awesome. And, you know, I love being able to do these virtual talent shows, and especially this particular month, and getting to connect with some Miss America organization title holders from across the country that typically we wouldn't have the opportunity to collaborate with and interact with. So thank you guys for being a part of this. I do have one more performance to show you, and I'm going to work on pulling that up and sharing my screen, which is not something I've had to do on my talent shows so far. So hopefully this will work. Okay. All right, let's see. And she's going to introduce herself. Hopefully you guys can see this.
Hey y'all, my name is Arielle Staffen. I'm the current Miss Central Jersey. I am New Jersey born and raised, a resident of Bridgewater, New Jersey. I'm also a student at Cornell University, go Big Red, where I'm a rising junior studying hotel administration. A little bit more about what I do within the Miss America organization. My social impact initiative is called SALUT, which stands for Serving, Advocating, Leading, Understanding, Teaching, and Empowering. And it focuses on spreading the stories of our servicemen and women, be that police officers or firefighters or military. I just salute looks to share their stories and hopefully bridge the gap between them and the people of the communities that they serve. So I'm currently a member of the Armed Forces. I'm in the New York State National Guard and in the ROTC program at my university. So this is just something that means a lot to me. And I absolutely love all of the work that I get to do through salute. So my talent on the Miss America stage is vocal percussion, which you may also know as beatboxing. So I'm super excited to share that with y'all tonight. So what I'll be doing is just a little clip of me freestyling some cool beats. So I hope y'all enjoy.
Yay! Y'all, okay, so I got a message while that was happening that might have been a little bit hard to hear, and if it was, I am totally down to play some of it again because it was that awesome. So if it may have been okay on Facebook. Okay, good, I hope so. Y'all can kind of let me know in the comments if that didn't come across as well. I'll check my phone right now. And I'm more than happy to grace everybody with that again, but it's really, really cool. And honestly, well, while that was happening and Ariel was sharing her talent, I was thinking Jocelyn and Ariel probably need to get together and do some type of like collaboration, you know? I think that'd be pretty cool. Some Miss America beatboxing, rapping type thing. I think that'd be pretty awesome. So y'all get connected, see what you can do there, maybe create some cool stuff together. Thank y'all so much for tuning in tonight. I usually end our shows with a little bit of singing from my end. Oh, look, Ariel's joining us. So Ariel couldn't be here with us live. I'm actually going to spotlight her. Hi.
Hi. Sorry I couldn't be there live. I had to pre-record it. I'm at training right now. But thank you all for watching.
Oh my gosh, I'm so happy that you joined in. Yay. Oh, cool. So let's talk for a second, actually, before I start singing. Cool. So I know that you kind of introduced yourself a little bit, but honestly, you're in uniform right now. So tell us a little bit about what you're doing this weekend and kind of how you got involved with that.
Yeah, of course. So I'm in the New York State National Guard. And so this weekend is one of our drill weekends. And then the next couple of weeks, we have our annual training. So I'll be chilling out in upstate New York for the next couple of weeks working with my unit. And yeah, it's a lot of fun. But I saw this opportunity. I didn't want to miss it.
Well, thank you so much for pre-recording that and putting that beautiful video together. It was so well edited as well. And before I say anything else, thank you for your service.
Thank you.
And for trading in your crown for different type of uniform and serving your community, not only as a title holder, but through the National Guard. That's incredibly admirable.
Thanks, Julia.
Absolutely. Thanks for popping on. I'm so happy to see you live.
we're just finishing up. So I was like, I have a minute and yours is still on.
Yay. Awesome. Awesome. Well, thanks for popping on. So like I said, typically we end with a little bit of singing on my end. So I'll be honest with you guys. I had a lot of trouble deciding what to do because I was like, there are all these incredible women. Like, what am I going to do? And honestly, I'm kind of going outside of my comfort zone a little bit, out of what I normally do. And I'm singing a song by a band that I really, really love. So I will be doing Open Arms by Journey. And it's just a quick little 90-second arrangement that I started learning this week. So fingers crossed, hopefully all goes well. But I am just thankful for the opportunity to share and am just so thankful for all of these beautiful young women who shared their heart and their talents with us tonight. All right, here we go.
Lying beside you, here in the dark, feeling your heart beat with mine. We sailed on together, we're drifting apart.
A friend of mine sent me that arrangement and I was like, oh my gosh, that's so fun. I want to learn that. So thank you for the opportunity to experiment and kind of go out of my comfort zone. For those of you who don't know, typically I am classical. That's my style. But during, these virtual talent shows, I kind of like to play around with different styles and challenge myself a little bit in my craft. So again, thank you to everybody who was a part of this tonight. I hope that you can see all of the ladies. If you guys want to wave and say hello, I'm so appreciative. And actually, while we're all on here, I normally forget to do this, but I want to take a selfie before we go off tonight and everybody jumps off. So what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to screenshot this on my on my MacBook. Let's do this. Oh, you all look so beautiful. Jenna, I don't know if you're there. If you're able to be on camera, we'll give her just a second and hopefully she can join in. You all look so beautiful. And if not, I'll just take a screenshot from earlier. So we'll jump on. Oh yeah, let's put the crowns and sashes on. And again, thank you guys so much for joining tonight. Be on the lookout for our next virtual talent show, which will be held in August. It will be an adult talent show. So if there are any parents or grandparents, aunts and uncles, teachers, literally anybody, if you are an adult and you have a special gift that you would like to share, shoot me a message and be on the lookout for advertisement for that coming up soon. All right, ladies, let's take this selfie. Let's do 1, 2, 3. Yay! And I'll send it to you guys. I'll email it. Thank you guys so much for joining. We're going to hop off. I hope you have an incredible weekend. And always remember that art is hope. See you guys next time.
There you go.